it's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip Bacardi like it's your birthday.
Thank you very much. This is quite an elite group, and we really thank you for letting us be here to see you today. When we found out, or I found out that we were playing, bringing up songs for us, I had to find out who 50 Cent was. So I immediately went to my pod and I asked them who 50 Cent was. So I thought the 50 Cent was really representing what my words are going to be worth that I'm giving you now. So we thank you for that. I also want to thank Dr. Atkins and Dr. Schleicher for having us come here today. We are still here as a part of COA and really represent the beginning of COA, but you guys are the future of COA. Being here with Dr. Schleicher feels feels appropriate because he's from Tennessee as I am. This all started in Memphis 20 years ago when a few of us got together, and as you've already heard from the Modernization Act, that something was going wrong and we needed to do something to preserve community oncology. We weren't looking 20 years down the road. We were concerned about just being able to stay in practice the next year. We didn't know anything about advocacy. We didn't know what to do about how to lobby, how to go up to Washington, how to try to influence what might happen as far as these things might go and to protect community oncology. One element that we never lacked was action. When we heard about the Medicare Modernization Act, we immediately started reaching out to our patients themselves to try to help us educate the people in Washington about the severity of the act itself and what it could do to community oncology. I think it was very interesting and very educational for me as well to see that happen, because when we asked for the patient's help, we asked for volunteers' help, we had literally hundreds of people come to Washington to help try to get our message across to everybody. And it was really a wonderful thing to see how many people were there and the impact that it had on Washington itself at that time. That was the start. It was that kind of take charge, don't quit attitude that served COA well over the years. As COA's first president, it's been immensely satisfying for me to watch COA grow into the organization it is today. It was a scrappy newcomer, if you will, with a voice among the oncology societies. I've watched COA progress from reacting to public policy to actually shaping it. Not bad for an organization that can't really legally drink yet. We're a long way from the first community oncology conference. In 2005, the first conference was just a few hundred folks, and today we have almost 2,000. So this year's conference is about all of COA's policy wins, and they're due in a large part to the leadership of the presidents who have succeeded me. After my term as president ended, I watched my successors pick up the torch of the community oncology and carry it proudly. Each president has an achievement that they're proud of, whether it's establishing the COA Administrators Network, starting the Payer Exchange Summit, or some of the other milestones. My proudest achievement is helping to found an organization that's helped such a lasting impact on cancer care and helped so many lives. 20 years ago when we started this, people said, what is COA? What is COA? And I said, well, it's not COA, it's COA. And what we would talk about is, it's Community Oncology Alliance. I love all three of those words, but the word I love the most is alliance, because that's what COA is. COA is an alliance of the clinicians and the business administrators, the clinicians, the physicians, the nurse practitioners, their staff, the business administrators, their staff, and the wonderful patients we take care of, all standing on the front line to fight this horrible disease. So that to me is what COA means. It's that what we do is we deliver the best and most recent scientific care possible, which you'll hear about today, along with the most efficient, financially feasible way to deliver that care in the community where that patient lives, with their family, in their social milieu that they need to live with, and give them the best possible care possible. That's what COA is. COA is not ASCO, COA is not and some NCCN, COA is grassroots. COA is where the rubber meets the road. We are the ones that take care of these patients. And their voice needs to be heard, and COA is the vehicle for their voice to be heard. So I think we should all give ourselves a big applause just for being that. Through these 20 years, I would be remiss if I didn't mention the lightning rod that's been part of COA. The very first meeting that we had with COA, Ted Okun was right there with us. He helped organize it. He did everything onto it. And I use the word lightning rod purposely because those of you that know Ted know he's kind of a lightning rod anyway. But he really has been the constant, the one thing that has gone with COA all along. He's had tons of help, and he'll tell you immediately that he couldn't have done it without a ton of help from a lot of many, many other people. But Ted's been the constant. All of us who know COA know Ted. And we really need to thank Ted so much. I personally thank Ted for what he's done. I think that all the people here at the conference thank Ted. But more importantly, millions of cancer patients that were able to get their care at home with their families need to thank Ted Okun. So let's give Ted a big hand. I often tell my staff that I wish I was 25 years old again, because the things that are going to happen in cancer in the next 5 years, maybe even the next 5 months, as fast as things are going, are going to be incredible to see. We need to be there. COA needs to be there, because somebody has to give this care to the patients, to their families, to the communities that they live in. Somebody has to do that, and that's what COA does. ASCO has its role, everybody else has their role, but COA has this unique role. So when people ask me what COA is, I tell them it's Community Oncology Alliance. It's not Hospital Oncology Alliance. It's not Large Research Association in a Big City Alliance. It's Community Oncology Alliance, delivering care in the most effective way, financially and scientifically, to where the patients live. This is a horrible disease. They need to be with their families. They need to be in their communities. And that's what COA does. Thank you all so much, and enjoy the conference.